This part of your glutes can refer pain to your low back, cause pain and stiffness in your hips, and also be part of your groin pain and tightness in the groin area. And in this video, we will be teaching you how to find these spicy parts from your glutes that cause these issues and how to release them properly and get relief. And first, a little bit of anatomy so that you know where to look for these problematic areas and to know what to avoid. So watch the whole video if you can. And yes, you can. The parts of the glutes that we are talking about are gluteus medius and minimus, both the anterior and posterior part of the gluteus medius and the whole minimus muscle. And they're located here on the side. People usually think that you have glutes only back there and they are for showing and shaking. Now you know that you have glutes on the sides and they have many purposes. These muscles stabilize your core and your hips, allowing you to walk normally without an excessive sway. These muscles also stabilize your knees. They prevent your knees from caving in, causing bad faulty loading to your knee joint and your kneecap. And these muscles also rotate your hip joint, and they rotate them externally and internally depending on the hip flexion angle and depending on the parts of the muscles, so anterior fibers versus posterior fibers. If these muscles are tight, it's hard to bring your leg across the other while sitting. Squatting might feel tight. You might get pressure in your hip, in your groin region. Weight bearing on the affected tight side might cause feelings of low back pain and hip pain and groin pain. These muscles are also the main culprits of gluteal tendinopathy. In gluteal tendinopathy, you don't want to stretch these muscles because the symptoms might get aggravated. So this is the perfect solution for you to release tension from these muscles without stretching. More on gluteal tendinopathy in the end of the video. Gluteus medius originates, so attaches from the iliac crest down to the trochanter major of your femur, your hip bone. Gluteus minimus attaches from the outer side of the ilium bone to also the trochanter major. Next, let's go into the release technique. But remember, if you have inflammations in the region, or you have bursitis near your trochanter, or you have fractures in the region, or you have been to a hip replacement surgery in your past and you haven't gotten the permission to go take massages to the region from your surgeon, then don't do this exercise. Or if you have any other medical reasons why you cannot massage the region, then don't do it. Okay, so the muscles are here on the side. Search first for your iliac crest. So below your rib cage, there's a soft spot where you have muscles, and straight down there you have the iliac crest. So it's the high part of your ilium. Then you go straight down from the crest, and here is the muscle. You don't want to go too much down because there is the bursa, and rubbing the bursa the wrong way can get it aggravated. Remember that you have to release the posterior parts, but also the anterior parts. Now you take a tennis ball or a massage ball, go against the wall, then add pressure. You should be able to locate a really painful spot. Then stay there, breathe 10 times slowly or more, don't choke. Then start to move slightly by shifting your weight forward and backward. This will release the muscle. Do this until the pain starts to fade, usually 2 to 3 minutes. But if it doesn't fade in this time, then just continue on by searching the next spot. Then put the ball a bit forward, a bit anteriorly, to see if these muscle fibers and myofascia have bad intents. And then if they have bad intents, then school them and show them who's the boss. Remember to go really anteriorly and release the myofascia there. And also release the posterior parts. So turn a little bit towards the wall with your back. So you get the posterior fibers of the gluteus medius muscle. Do this 2 to 3 times with recovery days between sessions. 3 times a week if you have really tough and tenacious tightness. Do not let the muscle win. Be consistent and do this for 2 to 4 weeks and you'll start noticing that the muscle isn't as tight anymore. If you have gluteal tendinopathy, this exercise is great for releasing tension, but you have to also remember that tendinopathic glute tendons like to be exercised and static isometric holds are great to begin with. Try to gradually increase the loading and screen the overall loading, meaning all the exercises that you do for your glutes and your walking bouts and other exercises that might load the tendon. The overall loading is the key to success. So don't overload, don't underload, but gradually increase the load tolerance. Maybe in the future we will do a video about glute tendinopathy or how to exercise different parts of your glutes. But now I heavily suggest checking out an exercise that will target glute minimus and medius all at once, and it's the bestest of all of exercises in the universe for this. It's that exercise there. Go check it out. Heippa!